Welcome to the very last lecture of Information Service Engineering. This is lecture number 14, ISE Applications, Part 2. As usual, before we go or come to the topics that we are talking about in this lecture, we have to do a brief recap of the last lecture. In lecture number 13, we started ISE Applications, and of course, for the first thing we had to do was to define what is Information Service Engineering. And to see how all of these things we did so far, NLP, knowledge graphs, as well as machine learning, really fit together to be able to build modern information systems that, of course, take care of structured and unstructured data and try to create, let's say, a user interface with which you are able to understand and to access this kind of data. So this is information service engineering. Then we had the question, how do we get from data to knowledge? Data alone, raw data, is more or less useless. You can't put it in perspective. It's not related to anything else. So the problem there is we have to come up with a process that transforms this data, first in information, to putting it in perspective with other data, and then into knowledge by simply then finding out about the principles, how these things are interconnected and why. And ultimately, we want to come up with wisdoms where we look behind the principles and can do predictions about the future. This process was referred to as knowledge mining or knowledge discovery. And we did many different examples there. So we did visualizations, we did knowledge mining, and we did data analytics, all based on the stuff we already did so far. So this means we made use of publicly available knowledge bases and knowledge graphs, extracted our data there, and then tried to do some analysis or prediction tasks. So this was subject of the last lecture. Now we come to further applications. And these applications then will be in the end related to search, web search. You remember this was our very first question, how to get information from the web, and you do this via web search engines. So to make use of semantic technologies within these kind of huge information systems, the web search engines, we have to create semantic annotations. So semantics has to be made explicit. Either the authors of the documents that have to be searched, they annotate their documents with semantic metadata, or the search engine has to do some kind of semantic analysis process on these documents to have then a semantic representation. And how to achieve these kind of semantic annotations, you will see in the first part of that lecture. As soon as we can access the semantics within these documents, be it text documents, be it pictures, videos, whatever, we can apply semantic search, and you will see that semantic search is much more powerful than the traditional search, because you know you can simply also make use of the document content beyond the usual back of words paradigm of the traditional search or information retrieval systems, because then you can really access the meaning of the content, and you can include external knowledge to find out more about the content you are searching for. We will see that semantic search enables you to get more precise and more complete search results. And we do many examples for entity-based search as well as for question answering, because together with a knowledge graph, a search engine or information system is also able to answer natural language questions. And how this works, we are going to show you there. A special case of semantic search is exploratory search, which is one of our most important research topics. What is exploratory search? Just imagine you are looking for something which is completely out of, let's say, the scope of your knowledge. You don't even know exactly what are the right terms I'm looking for. I only can try to paraphrase the stuff somehow. And then you see it will be difficult to find things like that in a search engine, because in a search engine, you have to use the right vocabulary. And even better, you are looking for something that you know, and you simply want to find it again. So this is then a typical retrieval question. But exploratory search is more. you have first to let's say to undergo some learning process to get information about what you really search exactly and how to phrase your search query. And this is a process of exploration, and exploratory search can do even more. It can also open up your pinpoint exact search that you usually have, and also give you results that are on the side, that are nearby, that are similar, that are related. So it opens up the entire search space and enables an exploration of what is there. And this exactly is not realized now with the most search engines. And we show you how this can be realized and show you also an example how it has been realized. Okay, so these are the very last topics we will go through in this last lecture of information service engineering. Now, for the last time, this is about an hour of new stuff. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the lecture.